Good morning, grade 10. We are doing topic 2, set 2.1 from the third question we are doing, which says that write the equations in ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 form and then write the values of a, b, c. So, three questions we have already done. This is our fourth question. So, first let us convert it into ax square plus bx plus c form. So, we have 3m square. This I am shifting, so minus 2m square plus 9 is equal to 0. Okay, so 3m square minus 2m square is 1m square plus 9 is equal to 0. So, comparing this with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we have a is equal to 1. We have b, there is no x term, so b will be equal to 0 and c will be equal to 9. Let's go for fifth problem. So, fifth question is p into 3 plus 6p, p into 3 plus 6p is equal to minus 5. Yes. Now let us open the bracket. So we have 3p plus 6 p into p is p square, which is equal to minus 5. Alright. Now let us rearrange it. So we have 6p square plus 3p plus 5 is equal to 0. Now comparing this with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to 6, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to 5. I hope it is clear, very easy. Let's go for the next problem. So this is your sixth problem. Let us solve it. X square minus 9, 13 taken over here, minus 13 is equal to 0. So, x square minus 13 minus 9 minus 22 is equal to 0. Compare this with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We get a is equal to, only x square means it is 1x square. So, we have a is equal to 1. Now, x term is not there. So, b will be equal to 0 and c will be equal to minus 22. Okay, now let's go for the fourth question. Now fourth question is determine if given values are roots or not. So equation given is x square plus 4x minus 5 is equal to 0 and x values they have given 1 and minus 1. What do you mean by being a root or being a solution? That means if I put x value over here, my left hand side should be equal to right hand side. What is my right hand side? 0. So, if I substitute x as 1 or x as minus 1 in this equation, then I should get answer as 0. If I get this answer as 0, then that particular value will be root. Now, see what I am doing is my left hand LHS. What is LHS? X square plus 4x minus 5. This is my LHS. And what is my RHS? RHS. My right hand side is 0. Yes or no? Now let us substitute first x is equal to 1. Okay. So substituting x is equal to 1. Please write. Substituting x is equal to 1. What I get over here now see? 1 square plus 4 into 1 minus 5. So let me find out RHS value after substituting x is equal to 1. 1 square is 1 plus 4 into 1 is 4 minus 5. 1 plus 4. 5 minus 5, how much I got? 0. So, 0 is my what? Left hand side. And what is my right hand side? Right hand side is 0, isn't it? So, what I get? 0 is equal. That means my left hand side is equal to right hand side, which I got as equal to 0. And therefore, x is equal to 1 is the root. Or you can also call it as a solution. It is a root or solution of the given equation. of the given equation. But we have done only with x is equal to 1. Now we have to try with x is equal to minus 1 as well. Okay. So now let us try with x is equal to minus 1. Alright. So let us try now. I am putting this here only. I am erasing. You have to do it again while you are writing in your notebook. Now substituting x is equal to minus 1. We have checked with plus 1. Now we are checking with minus 1. Now wherever there is x, I will be putting minus 1. And I have to check whether this value is coming 0 or no. So minus 1 the whole square plus 4 into minus 1. 4x. Between 4 and x there is multiplication sign. Minus 5. I am writing only one part, that is left hand side. Minus 1 square is 1 only. Minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1. Now plus 4 into minus 1 is minus 4. Minus 5. Alright. So 1 plus into minus. Minus 4 minus 5. Okay. So 1 minus 4 minus 5 will be minus 9. Alright. 1 minus 9 will be minus 8. Now minus 8 is not equal to 0. Because your RHS is 0. So we got LHS is not equal to RHS. And therefore minus 1 is not the root of the given equation. Are you understanding me? Okay, it is as easy as that. Let's go for next problem. Now this is your second equation. Again we have to check whether m is 2 or 5 upon 2 are solutions of this equation. So let us substitute. First we will write what is LHS. Left hand side is 2m square minus 5m. And what is your right hand side? Right hand side is 0. Now first substituting m is equal to 2. So wherever there is m, I am going to write 2. So 2 into m means I am going to write here 2 square minus 5 into 2. This is your left hand side. Okay. So 2 in 2 square is 4 minus 10. So 4 2's are 8 minus 10. So you have this is equal to minus 2. So we got this is what RHS. So RHS your this is LHS, sorry. LHS. So you got left hand side is equal to 2 and your RHS is 0. So we can write minus 2 is not equal to 0. Or we can write LHS is not equal to RHS. This sign is not equal to. And therefore, 2 is not the root. I hope it is clear. You may pause the video and take it down. Alright. Now let us check for 5 upon 2. So now here we are going to check it for 5 upon 2. So now 5 upon 2. So what is our LHS? We have 2m square minus 5m. Now wherever there is m, I am going to substitute 5 upon 2. So 2 into 5 upon 2. The whole square, because m is not only 5, it is 5 upon 2, so m square means this whole term square minus 5 into 5 upon 2. Okay, so this is equal to we have 2 into 5 square is 25 upon 2 square is 4. All right, minus 5 5s are 25 upon 2. Okay. Now here there is multiplication sign. So this can be cut off. 2 1's are and 2 2's are. So what I got? 25 upon 2 minus 25 upon 2. Sorry. 25 upon 2. Same terms we are subtracting. So 25 upon 2 minus 25 upon 2 will be equal to 0. So what you got? LHS. Is equal to 0. RHS is also equal to 0. So what we have? LHS is equal to RHS is equal to 0 and therefore 5 upon 2, no? And therefore 5 upon 2 is root. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now look at the fifth problem. They have already given x is equal to 3 is root. That means after substituting x is equal to 3 in this equation, we are going to get answer as 0. So I am substituting x is equal to 3. What I am going to get? K 3 square minus 10 into 3 plus 3. This value I am going to get it as 0 because it is given that x is equal to 3 is the root. Now what I get? 9k square minus 30 plus 3 is equal to 0. So what I have now? 9k square minus 27 is equal to 0. Dividing whole equation by 9. Dividing by 9. We have k square is not there, only k is there. Sorry. Dividing by 9, what do we get then? We get k minus 3 is equal to 0. Isn't it? Now, k will be equal to plus 3. X square was there, not k square. Okay. So, we got k is equal to 3. So, value of k is plus 3. It was easy. Alright. So, we'll stop here, students. Next problem, that is sixth one, we'll see in the next video. Thank you.